Well, woohoo! Welcome to Praise Center, Assembly of God today. It is a woohoo moment, isn't it? It's awesome to be in God's presence and in His house. I was just talking to some, and they were coming through the door this morning, how we walk into the house of the Lord. We may be tired. We might be a little irritated. Maybe we haven't had enough caffeine. Maybe we had too much caffeine. Maybe we didn't get enough sleep the night before. We didn't sleep in a Holiday Inn. We could go on and on. There could be reasons why we may or may not feel too good. But you walk into God's house and everything changes. Like everything that's out of place just goes right back into place. And you begin to feel the warmth of His presence and His love. Isn't the Lord good today? And how wonderful is it to be in God's house and to know the Creator? Just love Him so much. Let's stand and begin to praise Him and worship Him for all that He is today.
Amen. Let's give God praise. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah.
I was buried beneath my shame. And who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb till I met you. I was breathing, but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my tomb till I met you.
Oh, thank you, Lord. You called my name,
and I ran out of that grave.
Be joy in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Now your mercy has saved my soul. Now your freedom is all I know.
The old me knew Jesus when I made you. You called my name. I ran out of that grave. Glorious grace. You called my name. I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness, into your glorious day.
Yeah. I needed rescue. My sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your. I needed shelter, I was an orphan, but you called me a citizen of heaven.
When I was broken, you were my healing. Your love is the air that I'm breathing. I have a future, my eyes are open. And when you call my name, I ran out of that grave.
Time sing that. I needed shelter. I was an orphan, but you called me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you were my healing. Your love is the air that I'm breathing.
For future, my eyes are open, and when you call my name. I ran out of that grave.
I'm so thankful that God has called me out of darkness into light. Amen. He called anybody else out into the light? Oh, man, I'm so excited that you're here today. Turn to someone and give them a high five. Tell them you're glad they're in the Lord's house today. Amen. Your burden weighing heavy, is it all too much to carry? Oh, let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel? Because the shame is done, it's stealing. You're desperate for some healing. Oh, let me tell you about my Jesus. Yeah, well, he makes a way when there ain't no. Rises up from an empty grave. There ain't no sinner he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. The good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. And let my Jesus change your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, amen, amen, hallelujah, 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 amen, amen. Who can wipe away the tears, three broken dreams and wasted years? Tell the past to disappear. Oh, let me tell you about my Jesus. Amen, it's good, amen. Come on, let me tell you about my Jesus. Yeah, sing it out. Well, he makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty. There ain't sinner that he can't say. Let's tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. The good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. And let my Jesus change your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, amen, amen, hallelujah, 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 amen, amen, amen. Who would take your cross to Calvary, pay the price for all my guilt? Who would care that much about me? Oh, let me tell you about my Jesus. Oh. Well, he makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. The good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. And let my Jesus change your life. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 when we all get to heaven. What a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansion, bright and blessed, we'll prepare for us a place. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Let us truly be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will the total life repay. Oh, when we all get to heaven, oh, what a day of rejoicing that we see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. To the prize before us, soon this beauty will behold. Soon those pearly gates will open, we will tread the streets of gold. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Oh, we will sing and shout the victory. Yes, we will sing and shout the victory.
Yeah, give the Lord praise, amen.
And that's why we sing, how great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. All we'll see, how great is our God.
Come on, lift your voice.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. All we'll see, how great. How great is our God.
Name above. Come on, declare
it. You're the name above all names. You are worthy of all praise. Oh, my heart will sing. How great.
Come on, declare it today.
Yeah, your name above all names. You are worthy of all praise. Oh, my heart will sing. How great is our God.
How great.
See how great is our God.
Name above, one more time, declare with all your heart.
You're the name above all names. You are worthy of all praise, Lord. Oh,
great is our God. Come on, sing it out.
How great is our God. Now sing with me, how great is our God. All will see how great. How great is our God. Yeah, Lord, we worship you. We worship you. We worship you. Come on, give him praise today. Hallelujah. Oh, we praise your name. You're the name above all names. You are worthy of all praise. Oh, my heart will see how great.
Amen. Can you just lift your voice and praise to the Lord this morning? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My wife is coming at this time. You may be seated if you'd like to do so. God bless you today.
Praise your name. The Lord has, I'm going to keep it short this morning because we have a lot going on. But the Lord's put this in my spirit today. To them who sit in darkness, we have seen a great light. Matthew 4:16 says that the people living in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. Isn't that beautiful that we know at one time we were yet sinners? What does it say? And while we were yet sinners, what did Christ do? He died for us. While we were dirty, he died for us. When we were living in darkness, there was a great light that shined for us. We were able to follow that light out of the darkness and into a new life. God provided that for us. This is the season to recognize that great light. It's a beautiful light. The Lord is good. I have a few announcements today that I want to share with you. You can see that there are a lot of announcements here in the bulletin, but just some things that we want to point out, changes that don't normally take place in the week. So Wednesday at 5:30 will be the pot blessing. So I know that is a potluck blessing, but maybe here you guys call it a pot blessing. We call it a potluck blessing in Texas. So. Okay, so it's a pot blessing full of blessing and no luck. So we're going to throw the luck out the door because we believe in blessings, right? No luck involved. Our ladies know how to cook really well. So they are skilled and talented. No luck needed. And a White Elephant gift exchange. The White Elephant gift exchange will be at 6 p.m. 6 p.m. is worship. And the White Elephant exchange will be that night as well. So King's Kids, Youth Connect, after worship. The youth are going to stay in here. I'm not sure about King's Connect, but the youth will stay in the building for the White Elephant. So everyone who wants to play the game of the White Elephant Exchange, please bring a gift with you. So youth, bring a gift. Doesn't have to be anything pricey or expensive. Something around your house that you've never used that maybe someone else can use. You know, I've seen all kinds of things. I've seen rolls of toilet paper, Preparation H, hand lotion, denture cream. Maybe you were too young and someone gave you denture cream and you don't need it anymore. Well, or you never needed it. Hopefully you never will. Bring that. That's a wonderful White Elephant gift that someone might enjoy. So Wednesday, December 20th, that is going to take place. Also remember to wear an ugly Christmas sweater. The most ugly Christmas sweater will get a prize. So if you have the ugliest Christmas sweater, I'm guessing that that will be voted upon. And you will be deemed the person with the most ugly Christmas sweater. And then you will get a gift. How wonderful is that? So there will be no 10:30 a.m. service on 12/24. No 10:30 a.m. service because that evening we're going to be having a Christmas Eve candlelight service. We would love to have you join us for that. That will be at 6 p.m. So please join us for that. On the back, you can see the ways that you can give and serve the church. We would love to have you be a part. If you're a first-time guest today, we are so glad to have you. We hope that you feel right at home. Over on our Christmas tree, let's remember we have a few Christmas angels left. If you haven't brought your gift back today, it needs to be brought back by Wednesday, because next Sunday the kids will pick up the gifts. So the rest of the angels that are left on the tree, if someone is needing to buy a gift for an angel, there are a few left. Please, let's make sure those all go out today. We bring our gifts back on Wednesday. They will be picked up on Sunday. Thank you so much. We love you all very much, and we're so glad to be a part of this church family. Merry Christmas to all of you.
Christmas. Amen. Stay with you. You can stay with me. Hey, today we have a special, special service for you. There's a lot going on today, but one of the most important things that we're doing today is we are dedicating a baby to Jesus. And so I want to invite Gabe and Kara and their family at this time, and all their family, the Fordall family, and anybody else here that has come to be with you today. And we're just delighted. Bring that baby boy up here. Amen. Amen. Jackson Everett, we're so delighted to have you here in the house. And Gabe, I want you to know, brother, I love you and I appreciate you, man. We just stand with you and we support you and your family. Amen. I have just a few verses I want to share with you this morning, and I promise not to preach. If I get too long-winded, just be like, preacher, cut it short. Amen. But I think one of the verses that really just stood out in my heart this week is as I was praying and asking the Lord what to share, because there's many, but it's Deuteronomy chapter 6. And verse number 4 and through verse 9, and it says, "Listen, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. And you must love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all of your soul and with all of your strength. And you must commit yourselves wholeheartedly to these commands that I am giving you today." And this is the one that I really want y'all to put in your heart, is verse 7. "Repeat them again and again to your children. Talk about them when you are at home and when you are on the road and when you are going to bed and when you are getting up." And I know that y'all do a lot of driving. So when y'all are coming back and forth from South Tucson over here, I encourage you to just talk about the Lord in your car. But verse 8 says to tie them on your hands and wear them around your forehead as a reminder, and to write them on the doorpost of your house and on your gates. And I just want to challenge you today as your pastor to raise up Jackson Everett in honor and in holy fear and reverence to the Lord. And if you can do that, would you say, "I will"? Amen. All right. And you know what, church? The challenge is not only to this family, but it's to us as well. And I want to share a passage with you found in Hebrews chapter 10. I promise you I'm not preaching now, but I will share this quickly. And I just pray that it'll stir our hearts as a church family. And it says there in Hebrews 10 and 23, "Let us hold tightly without wavering the hope that we affirm, for God can be trusted to keep his promise. Let us think of ways," hear this, church, "let us think of ways to motivate one another to acts of love and good works." Wow. Church, can we do this for this family? Can we motivate them in good ways for love? And then he says in verse 25, "And let us not neglect our meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but let us encourage one another, especially now that the day of his return is drawing near." Church, if you can do that, would you say, "I will"? I will help this family with that. I will. Amen. What an honor. We have a small gift that we want to give to you this morning. This is for your family, and this is for little baby Jackson to grow into. And there's a certificate in there as well that we want to sign here at the end. And it is kind of heavy. It's the Word of God. So, you know, it's coming out at the bottom down here. But And little brothers may jump on that as well. Yeah, something for the whole family to enjoy. Amen. But I'd like to take this opportunity. If Jackson will let me hold him, I want to pray over him and bless him today. Oh, my goodness. Can somebody get a picture of this? Wow. Hey, big guy. You make the pastor look 10 years younger. Amen. We want to pray over baby Jackson Everett. Church, would you stand with me this morning, and would you pray with me? Lord, we just lift up Jackson to you today, Lord. And we pray, Lord, that all the days of his life would be blessed. We pray that your hand will be on him all the days of his life. And God, that you will lead him and guide him and direct him. Lord, that he would grow in knowledge and wisdom of you. Lord, that you will fill him even today with your Holy Spirit. And God, that you will keep him all the days of his life, Lord. Oh, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you would set a hedge of protection around him. Lord, we honor you today and we anoint this baby. We ask, Lord, that you would anoint him with your Holy Spirit, God. Lord, that you will fill him and that you will be with him. Lord, we do not place a limit on you. We do not place any limits on you, God. Lord, whatever you desire to do with Jackson, Lord, we commit his life to you today. And we bless him today. We bless this family today. We bless little Jackson today, God. May the supernatural favor of God rest on his life. We ask these things. And Lord, give just a special grace to mom and dad. Let your peace, Lord, which passes all understanding, just rest on them. Lord, I thank you that you are Jehovah Jireh. You are the Lord who provides. And I pray, Lord, you know one of their prayers is they've been praying for a new home. And I pray, God, that you would honor that request. Lord, we lift it up to you, Lord. We ask, God, that you would honor that request and that in 2024, this family would find a new home to live in. Closer to the church, their desires to be closer here, God. And we ask, Lord, that you would do that for them. We love you so much, Lord. And we thank you for this day, and we give you the highest praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. There you go, Dad. Amen. Love you guys. God bless you. Amen. Amen. God bless you, sister. Amen. Love you. Love this family. Love y'all. Love you. Yes, amen. Love these boys. These boys are going to be some preachers someday. I'm telling you. All right, all right. Well, let's take just a few moments to go. It's our practice here to go amongst each other and greet one another. So I think right now would be a good time to do that. Our youth are coming. They're going to do a presentation for us in just a moment. But can we take just a minute to go to one another, greet one another, give each other a handshake, maybe a high five, maybe a hug. Let somebody know that you are glad they are here today. God bless you. Right. I want to invite Layla's coming to share a special at this time. And I wanted to give our youth pastor, Elizabeth, a chance just to greet you this morning and just to say a few words. So, Elizabeth, come and greet as Layla's getting ready for her special this morning.
Morning, everybody. It is wonderful to be in the house of the Lord. And can I just say I'm very proud of our youth students. Y'all did phenomenal. So proud of you guys. They've been working on that for a few weeks. Also, we're about to have an amazing special from one of our students. Her name is Layla, and she's going to be playing a violin special. So please give it up for Layla.
That's the wrong. You may have to help your dad because you know this piano better than I do. So, I'm so sorry. Turn it off and then turn it back on, right? There it is. There we go. Thank you.
Wasn't that great? All right. I want to invite our children's pastor up at this time, and they have a presentation they're going to do as well. Can you make Marissa welcome this morning? Come on up, Sister Marissa. God bless you. And do we want to invite the children on up as well? And the children can come up as well at this. Yes. And the mic stand. Here's this one for sure. Yeah. It may not be on the bottom.
Here we go. Amen. Are you excited to be in the house of the Lord?
All right.
Man.
Yeah.
These kids have been working hard on their wonderful song and their verse. We also have BGMC today, but we wanted to bless you with song, okay? So can I, Sister Tina, can I get you on up here to help me get the kids here in place? Come on, guys, move down a little. Okay, Finn, you're gonna be on the outside. Yeah. As we get the kids together, we just wanna say a big thank you to our parents who practice with the kids. I cannot say thank you enough for that. But they've been doing great. And we want to ask for your participation this morning with our song, because we come to glorify the Lord and worship together and lift up his name. So can you guys help us with our song today? Awesome.
Heralded by the angels, born in a lowly manger, the Virgin Mary was his mother, and Joseph was his earthly father. Three wise men came from afar, they were guided by a shining star, to see King Jesus where he laid in the manger, filled with hay.
New life, new hope, new joy he will bring. Amen. We're going to end our with a verse that we've been learning, one that has been done today. But you know what? The word of the Lord is so good. I think we need to hear it one more time. Are you kids ready?
Isaiah 9:6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders.
Amen, amen. Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Man, I am so excited. We are now going to collect for our BGMC. And Pastor Mo, correct me if I'm wrong, we have made our 2023 goal. We have made our 2023 goal. Amen. So what we get today will be going towards our next year, 2024. And if you guess the amount, yes, we go with the year. So next year's goal is $2,024 for us to raise to change our life around the world. So we give change to make a change. So whatever the Lord puts upon your hearts, we thank you. Thank you so much. Praise Center, thank you. There we go. Please raise your hand if you have changed. The kids will be right to you as soon as they can. Thank you.
Well, our children are going next door at this time. They're going to have a celebration. They're going to have a little party over there. I don't want to see any of you big kids exiting and heading over for the party, okay? So, man, don't you just love our kids? I tell you, man, Man, my heart's just bubbling this morning. I just am so blessed by our children, by our youth, by the baby that I held in my hands this morning. Oh, my goodness. I just praise God for what he's doing. If you're here and you're a guest today, we want to just say welcome. We're so glad that you're with us today. We are just family. And so what you see is what you get. You know, there's no put on here for you. We're just real. We're just real. And so sometimes your pastor will cry when the Spirit of God moves on him, and that's okay. You know, sometimes we shout a little bit. Sometimes we laugh. If anything, I've learned to laugh at myself, you know. But we want to say welcome. We're glad you're here today. BGMC, if you're not familiar with what that is, it's Boys and Girls Missionary. It used to be called Missionary Club, and then they changed it to Missionary Challenge, okay? But basically, all this money that comes in goes to support our missionaries, and it goes out to help people know that there is hope. And Jesus is that hope today. I tell you what, you've already heard a great message this morning about Jesus is wonderful. Amen. He is a counselor. He's the mighty God. He's the everlasting Father. I don't know that I can add to that today. I'm going to try my best, you know. But I do want to say welcome today. And if you're here, you're a guest, we'd love to have you back. Wednesday night would be a great opportunity to come back and just come and be a part of our White Elephant gift exchange. Normally we do a meal on Wednesday nights. We're going to have a meal this week where we all bring a, what was it, a pot blessing. Pot blessing. And so I've already been kind of thinking about what I want to bring. I hope you're thinking about what you might want to bring. But, you know, the main thing is bring yourself and let's just have a good time, right? And so we want to invite you. That begins at 5:30. So the meal will begin at 5:30. Then at 6 p.m. we'll have a brief time of praise and worship. And then we'll have the gift exchange, all right? So I'm excited to see what some of these gifts are. Leah gave you some really... I won't even go there because I just be honest, when she started saying that, I was like, oh, there went the anointing. It just went out the back door, you know. No, I'm just teasing. Amen. If you have your Bible today, we're in Luke chapter 1. Luke chapter 1. And today the title of the message is Mary, Did You Know? I love that song, by the way. We did sing it Wednesday night, and what a beautiful rendition. The song is actually written by Mark Lowry, and I just think it's incredible because Mark Lowry is a great musician, he's a great singer, but if you really know Mark Lowry, he's a cut-up, he's a comedian, he's a Christian comedian. And he'll have you laughing 1 minute, and the next second he'll have you crying because he'll say something that'll just, you know, tug at your heart and touch your heart. But I think it's pretty cool that God put this song in this man's heart, and he put it to pen back in 1984. And little did he know that that song would go all the way around the world. And there have been countless musicians and artists, both Christian and secular, that have recorded this song, Mary, Did You Know? And I want to attempt today, I preached this last year, but the Lord's given me some fresh nuggets. So it's not the same message. So some of you that were here last year, you're like, oh, I think I've heard him preach this before. No, you haven't heard me preach this one before. The vehicle's the same. The people that are in the vehicle are a little different. Luke chapter 1, verse 26. If you have your Bible, that's where we're at this morning. Luke chapter 1, verse 26. I'm reading this morning from the Living Bible. The following month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a village in Galilee, to a virgin, Mary, engaged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Congratulations, favored lady." I love that language. I picked this translation because of that. "Congratulations, favored lady. The Lord is with you." Confused and disturbed, verse 29, confused and disturbed, Mary tried to think what the angel could mean. Verse number 30, "Don't be frightened, Mary," the angel told her, "for God has decided to wonderfully bless you. Very soon now, you will become pregnant and have a baby boy, and you are to name him Jesus. And he shall be very great and shall be called the Son of God. And the Lord God shall give him the throne of his ancestor David. And he shall reign over Israel forever. And the kingdom shall never end." Exclamation mark. I like that. His kingdom shall never end. Verse 34, Mary asked the angel, "How can this be? How can I have a baby? I am a virgin." She's curious. Verse 35, the angel replied,
the Holy Spirit shall come upon you, and the power of God shall overshadow you. So the baby born to you will be utterly holy, the Son of God. Furthermore, six months ago, your Aunt Elizabeth, the barren one, they called her, became pregnant in her old age. Verse 37, this is key. For every promise from God shall surely come true. Somebody needs to hear that today. For every promise of God shall surely come true. God don't just say things to be saying things, church. When God speaks, you can count on it. His promises are yea and yea. They are yes and yes. They are amen and amen. The word amen, do you know what it means? So be it. So be it. I'm preaching this morning. Somebody needs to hear that today. Every promise from God shall surely come true. Verse 38, Mary said, I am the Lord's servant, and I am willing to do whatever he wants. Wow. May everything you said come true. And then the angel disappeared. Father, we pray today for the reading of your word, and I ask, Lord, for your anointing just to rest on this place and on your people, on the hearts of men and women, on our ears today. God, give us hearts to respond to your word. God, give us ears to listen and hear what you are saying. And Lord, help us to answer your calling. Help us to answer as you prompt us and as you prod us today, Lord. We'll be faithful to give you all the praise, Lord. In the marvelous name of Jesus, the name that's above every name, the name of Jesus, everyone said, amen, amen, hallelujah. So the title of the message, Mary, Did You Know? Well, I want to emphatically, profoundly say, yes. I think she knew some things. First of all, the angel of the Lord came to her. I don't know if you've ever experienced anything like that. I, for one, have not. But every time I read in Scripture, when an angel of the Lord comes to someone, what do they say first off? They say, fear not. Do not be afraid. That tells me the angels must be some bad to the bone guys. You know, some bad to the bone dudes, some ladies. I won't put a gender on them, but they are bad to the bone. Because every time in Scripture, when they appear to someone, the first thing they say is, don't be afraid. And yet I'm reminded that the Scripture tells me that he's got his angels watching over you and me. You know, there's things that happen sometimes in life that we just can't explain. I don't have time to preach it today, but there was a time when I was 10 years old, and I was out in the middle of a highway, a busy highway, and but God, I wouldn't be here today, because there was a car that was coming over the hill at 55 miles an hour, and I knew in my heart that it was about to hit me. As a matter of fact, I embraced for impact, and I uttered the words, Jesus. It wasn't a curse word. It was a prayer, church. And honestly, I don't even think I got the word out in time. But somehow, some way, that car did not hit me. Could it have been that the angels of the Lord were watching over me? I don't know. But I want to say that Jesus made a way, and I'm here today because of it. And you, too, can probably look back on your life and pinpoint times in your life when you say, man, I don't understand it. I can't explain it. But God, you know. And I think that this is what Mary must have experienced. She's startled, right? She's like, oh, my goodness. And the angel of the Lord comes to her. And so I want to attempt to answer some of these questions today. Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? I'm not sure that I can answer this one, but I picture baby Jesus. You know, I'm not sure that I can answer it exactly, but I often wonder, what did Mary see? What did she see when Jesus was growing up? And I picture a young boy, Jesus, holding maybe a small bird in his hands, and just maybe that bird has a broken wing. And I see young Jesus saying to Mama Mary, "Look, Mama," and I can just see him blow on that baby bird. And all of a sudden, those wings start to flapping, and all of a sudden, that bird comes back to life, and that bird just takes off. I don't know for sure if that might have happened, but I'm asking you today to imagine with me what Mary might have seen. Or I can see Mary and Jesus walking on the shores of Galilee, and all of a sudden, Jesus just takes off, running across the water, not walking, but he's running, and he scampers out across the water. And I can see Mary saying, "Jesus, you get back over here right this minute. You get back over here." What would the neighbors think? I don't know if that might have happened, but if you can imagine with me, if Mary was like my mama, you know, my mama, "I've told you once, I've told you 1,000 times, you better get back over here and get in line. I'm telling you right now." I don't know if it might have happened, but I want to put in your heart today this thought. What did Mary see, and what did she know? And I just love the heart of this young lady, because she responds to the Lord, or the angel of the Lord. And the scripture says in verse 35 that the Holy Spirit, because she's curious, right? She's curious, and she's like, "How can this be? I'm a virgin," you know? She's curious. She's not saying, "How can this be? I'm a virgin." No, she's like, how can this be? And she's curious. And the angel of the Lord says that the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of God will overshadow you. I don't know about you, but I need the power of God in my life to overshadow me. I need the Holy Spirit in my life to overshadow my life. I need Him every day. The scripture says in Psalm 91, "He that dwells in the secret place shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty." What does that word mean, dwell? It means to abide. It means to live. Can I encourage you to live and to abide and to dwell in the secret place? Well, where is that secret place? Well, Jesus talks a little bit about that secret place in Matthew 6:6. "But when you pray," Jesus said, "He said, enter into your closet, and when you have shut the door," some of us need to shut the door on the enemy today. You need to just shut the door on the enemy. He's a liar. The scripture says that he is the father of all lies. I want to encourage you, I implore you today to shut the door on that liar. And go into that secret place. Jesus says, when you pray, enter into your closet. And when you have shut the door, he says, pray to your Father, which is in secret. And your Father, which sees in secret, will reward you openly. Oh, man, that gets me excited. Let me tell you why, because that tells me that God don't keep secrets. When we go to Him in secret, He says, I'm going to reward that person openly. I'm going to bless that person openly. Why? Because they've come to me in the secret place. And I'm about to get excited up in here. Can I encourage you to abide, to live, to dwell in the secret place? And you know what I've learned is the secret place can take place in your car going down the road. Now, don't close your eyes when you're driving. I mean, now some of you need to close your eyes when you're driving because you got them wide open and it ain't helping you at all. So some of you just need to close. What I'm trying to say to you today is that God speaks everywhere we go. Man, I've heard Him in the grocery store. I've heard Him in the car going down the road. I heard Him at Speedway a couple of weeks ago. I shared that with you. God put it in my heart to pray with a young man there at Speedway. I want to tell you today, the secret place can take place anywhere that you allow God to dwell in your life. If you'll allow him to abide with you and dwell with you. You know, I'm going to tell you something crazy. One time, not too long ago, I was watching a basketball game. And all of a sudden, I felt the Holy Spirit say to me, "Hey, can I watch this game with you?" And I said, "Well, all right, Lord, come on in and watch this game with me." And I know you're thinking that, man, Pastor Mo is done falling off. He's lost it. But I did. I said, "Holy Spirit, you're welcome." And you know what? The Holy Spirit started telling me about one of the guys that was playing that game. And he started talking to me about a young man. He said, "I love that young man. Man, he is talented." And he said, "But the reason I love him is because he gives all credit and all glory to me." And he, because I think I needed to hear that. Because sometimes we get self-righteous. And I had heard a few interviews with this guy, and sure enough, he did. He would give God praise, and he would give glory to God. But I also saw him on the court, and sometimes when everything didn't go his way, he let out a curse word or two, you know. And so I was thinking, man, that guy, man, he really needs to get right with God. And the Holy Spirit comes in the scene with me in the room and says, "I really love that young man. He's got some things he needs to work on, but I love that young man." Church, do you hear me today? Amen. He's working on all of us. Glory to God. He's working on all of us. And he is faithful to see us through. I'm thankful for his faithfulness. Oh, I give God praise. And I just love the heart of Mary. She says in verse 37, I love her response. She says, actually, in verse 38, I'll go back to verse 37 in a moment. But she says in verse 38, she says, "I am the Lord's servant." And there's not a better title than that. Because I read in Scripture, when we go to heaven, he says, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant." No better title than the title of servant. There's no better. He doesn't say, "Well done, thou good and faithful pastor." I'm preaching to the pastor this morning. He doesn't say, "Well done, thou good and faithful worship leader." I'm preaching to worship leaders this morning. Hallelujah. He doesn't say, "Well done, thou good and faithful Sunday school teacher." Praise God for the Sunday school teachers. We need Sunday school teachers. We need pastors. We need worship leaders. We need youth pastors. But we need men and women of God that would say, "I'm just a servant. Lord, I'm just a servant." And Mary says, "I'm just a servant." And she says, "Let it be according to your word." And the angel of the Lord departed. Now, what you need to know is the verse before that. Mark and I were talking about this a couple weeks ago, brother. So I'm preaching this message, you know. I'm trying to give you a little credit here, you know. But this verse, and I love the American Standard Version. It actually, American Standard Version is a word-for-word translation. NIV is a great, I love NIV, but it's more of like a thought per thought at times and things like that. But this one is a literal word-for-word translation. In Luke 1 and 37 says, if you translate it in the American Standard Version, "For no word from God shall be void of power." That's what it's really saying there. No word from God is void of power. We know it as, "For with God nothing shall be impossible." That's a great translation. But the scripture, if we break it down word for word, no word from God shall be void of power. God is not lacking in power. He is not void of power. I love what Isaiah 55:11 says. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth, and it shall not return to me void. In other words, it shall not return to me lacking in power, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the very thing for which I sent it. When God gives a word, you better believe it. Amen. It's going to happen whether we like it or not. Amen. He's maker of all. He is all. He is my all and all. And I love Mary's response. She says, Lord, I'm just your servant. I'm just your servant. May it be exactly as you say. I love Mary's faith. It is Mary who actually provokes Jesus' first miracle. Do you remember that? In John chapter 2, they're there for the wedding feast. There's a wedding feast that's taking place, and they've run out of wine. They've run out of wine. Oh, man, what a terrible predicament to be in. Now, I love the Jewish culture, because when they party, they party, man. It's like a 7-day-long feast, all right? So when we get to heaven, y'all better be ready. We're going to celebrate for a little while, okay? Y'all ain't excited about that? I'm telling you, man, I'm ready to celebrate, man. That's going to be fun. But this family, they had allowed the wine to run out, and so Mary, remember, she's seen some things. She had to have, right? She had to know some things. And she goes to Jesus in verse 4, John 2 and verse 4, and she says, hey, we need to help this family out. And Jesus is like, Lord, like, Mama, my time has not come yet. And what does she do? Like a good old mother, she says to the servants there, she says, whatever he tells you to do, do it. That's a good word for us today, church. Whatever the Lord speaks, whatever he says to us, oh, God, I'm just your servant. I'll do it. And so what does he tell them to do? He tells them to take these jars, these vast jars. And honestly, John 2 and 6, really what it's saying there is take these Jewish ceremonial washing jars. Take these out and fill them to the brim. You know, it would have been easy for those servants to say, wait a second, Lord. These are Jewish ceremonial washing jars. These are set aside for that purpose and that purpose alone. How many times do we do that with God? God challenges us in an area and we're like, oh, I don't know if we can do that. I'm challenging you today to say, Lord, I'm just a servant, and whatever your word is, I'll do it. That was Mary's heart. Oh, I don't know if I can do that. I love Mary's spirit. She has a willing spirit. Psalm 51 and 12, grant me a willing spirit to sustain me. That's what the psalmist wrote. Our prayer should be, God, give me a willing spirit to sustain me. Not only that, she had an obedient heart. God, give me an obedient heart to do whatever you're calling me to do. Give me an obedient heart. The word of the Lord was spoke through the prophet Samuel in 1 Samuel 15 and 22. And he speaks to King Saul and he says, what is more important, King? What is more important, pleasing the Lord with your burnt offerings and sacrifices or your obedience to his voice? Listen. Obedience is better than sacrifice. And submission is better than offering the fat of rams. You see, the king had brought an offering. He had brought a sacrifice, but he had not been obedient to what God had told them to do. And as a result, it brought a curse on their land and it brought a curse on them. They're still dealing with it even to this day. Church, I want to encourage you today that we have to have a willing spirit and we have to have an obedient heart. And a few weeks ago, we had a revival out here. And on Friday night, there came a prophetic word. And I've wrote this word down in my journal. I've wrote it on the tablet of my heart. And I want to encourage you to write it down in your spirit. And the word was basically, I can sum it up with this one word. Advance was the word. Amen. Advance. And I'm praying about this, you know, our 2023 theme was love God, love people. We're going to continue to love God and love people in 2024. But I'm praying about our theme for 2024, that our theme would be advance. 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 The word advance can be defined this way: to accelerate the growth or progress of something. Advance a cause. To bring or move forward, to raise to a higher rank or a higher level. God, let us advance your kingdom. Let us advance what it is you were calling us to do. That is my prayer. In Mark 7 and verse 5, the elders came to Jesus. And they said, why don't your disciples follow our age-old traditions? They eat without first performing the hand-washing ceremony. The very thing that those jars were used for was a hand-washing ceremony. And these elders come to Jesus and they say, hey, your disciples are not following our age-old tradition. And I really like the wording there that they use. They eat without first performing the hand washing ceremony. And what God has put in my spirit to challenge you with is this: God does not need another performance. He does not need another performance. A matter of fact, I would say to you that performance makes the Lord sick. Because I read in Isaiah that my righteousness, what I'm saying today, church, when I have my best suit on and I have my vest and my tie on and I'm looking good, on my very best day, Isaiah says that my righteousness compared to God's righteousness is filthy rags. So God doesn't need me to come up here and perform for you. It makes him sick. We don't need entertainment. I praise God for our worship team, and they do an excellent job. Praise God for that. But we don't need another performance. And Jesus says to the men who ask him this, Jesus says, man, Isaiah spoke of you well. He said, you would honor me with your lips, but your heart is far from me. And I'm telling you, church, that we've got to be a people that get back to the place where our hearts honor God. We don't just pay him lip service. Oh, I'm a Christian. Always getting quiet up in here. But we don't perform, amen, but we honor God with our hearts. And Jesus said to them, basically, you can go read it there in Mark 7 and 5. But he said, you ignore God's law and you substitute your own traditions. Wow. No wonder they wanted to take him out and stone him, but he spoke the truth. Oh, praise center, never let it be said of us that we honor manly traditions, but we honor the heart of God. We honor the heart of God. We're following hard after you, Lord. And maybe you're here today and you say, Pastor, life is hard. It's difficult. I get it. I get it. Maybe you're here today and you're like, man, this just like that wine ran out. I feel like I'm running out. I'm tired. Maybe the joy has ran out this Christmas. Maybe love has escaped you. Maybe peace has ran out on you today, but I want to put an emphasis on this. I am limited. You are limited, but not God. He's not limited, church. He is not limited. I want to submit this thought to you, and I'm closing in just a few seconds, a few moments, I promise you. God is the inexhaustible fountain. Man, I almost shouted right there. He is the inexhaustible fountain. There is an overflow of self-sufficiency in our God. He is all-sufficient. He is all-knowing. He is all-powerful. He is giver to all. He owns it all. He is helper to all. And you know what else is? He is sustainer of all. He is sustainer of all. And I want to submit to you this thought today. I am limited, but God is not. And if you're here today and you feel a prompting, maybe I call them little doodaddies that go up and down your neck. That's the Holy Spirit. And He loves you. And I want you to know there's a place for you here at Praise Center. God loves you. We love you. We'd love for you to say, hey, I want to be a part of this thing you call family. But I love Mary, and I love her heart. And I want to answer this question. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Mary, did you know that the child that you soon delivered would soon deliver you? Amen. We're coming into celebration time. Hallelujah. We celebrate Advent. We celebrate Christmas. We celebrate the birth of our Savior. And it's not just about baby Jesus. Amen. But it's about King Jesus. And I read the scripture. I read in scripture where these wise men traveled a great distance to worship the Lord. And the scripture says in Matthew 2 and 10 that they presented unto Him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. I want to submit this thought to you. It was a king's offering to this baby king. How else do you think that they were able to escape and just automatically just go to Egypt for some time? Because the angel of the Lord comes to them and warns them, do not go back to Galilee. Do not go back that way, right? I believe it's because these men, these wise men, show up and present to them a king's ransom, a king's gift. And they go off to Egypt. And then when the time was right, they come back to fulfill His calling. Mary, did you know? And I want to say a resounding yes, she knew. Yes, she knew that her baby would save the sons and daughters. Matthew 1 and 21, the word of the Lord came to Joseph, and she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for He will save His people from their sins. If you're here today, maybe you've never heard this story. But I want you to know that the scripture tells us in John 3 and 16, for God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. I'm going to tell you, this world that we live in, it is broken. And people want to step on you and want to hurt you and harm you and take from you and just steal from you. But not our God. He's a giver. He's a giver of hope. He's a giver of life. If you're here today and you'd say, hey, I want some of that, I got both hands raised. Amen. I got both hands raised. And I want to invite you, church, to pray a prayer with me today. If you're here today and you'd say, yes, I want to make Jesus my Lord. Yes, I want to make Him my Savior. The Bible says in Romans 10 and 13, whosoever calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. I want to invite you today to call on His name. So would you pray with me today? I want to lead you in prayer. Would you repeat after me today? And if that's you today, and you mean it from the bottom of your heart, just pray it aloud with me today. Church, would you help me pray? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus. And we just say yes. Yes to this wonderful gift. I say yes to salvation. I say yes to love. I say yes to hope. I say yes to peace. I say yes to joy. And I welcome you, Lord, into my heart. Lead me. Guide me. Direct me in every aspect of my life. I'm just your servant. Do what you will do. Let every word be accomplished as you have spoken it. I simply say yes. In the marvelous name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Can you give God praise today? If you're here today and you've prayed that prayer, maybe you've prayed that prayer for the first time, I just want to say welcome to the family. It's really that simple. It's welcome to the family. And we are here. This is just the beginning of your journey. It's just the beginning. We are here to encourage you along this path of life. And we want to invite you to come and make this your church home. We want to put some things in your hand to encourage you and strengthen you in the faith of God. We have classes, we have Bible studies, we have all kinds of stuff that takes place here throughout the week. And if you're here and this is the first time you've ever prayed that prayer, praise God, welcome to the family. If you're here today and maybe you're just saying, Pastor, I just needed to rededicate my life today, that's okay too. And we welcome you into the family of God. Amen? Amen. I want to invite you this Wednesday night, remember our fellowship time together. Remember our pot blessing meal. It's definitely going to be blessed because we've talked about it about three or four times. That starts at 5:30 this Wednesday night. And then at 6 p.m. we'll have a time of worship. And then we will have the white elephant gift afterwards. Listen, I'm transparent. I'm just a book. That's who I am. I'm open. And a few months ago, several months ago now, probably 6 or 7 months ago, that God laid on my heart to close our time at the church by opening the altars and asking the people to come and spend time in prayer. And I was praying one day up here, and God really convicted my heart. I'm praying and I'm asking God, I'm saying, God, we really want revival. We really want revival here. And it's just like the Holy Spirit just spoke to my heart and said, I'm going to send revival, but I can't because you won't open the altars up. And I was like, ouch. And so since that time, I have tried to be very faithful to that. So if you're here today and you can spend a few moments in prayer with us here in a moment, we're going to Ricky, if we could maybe play some piano music back there. But if you can you come and spend a few moments in prayer with us around the altar today? And then if you're here today and you say, Pastor, I've got a special need. I really need prayer in this area of my life. After we prayed for a few moments, if you'd just stand around here at the front, Leah and I would be glad to stand with you, pray with you, encourage you in the Lord today. If you have to slip out, I totally get it. I totally understand it. Sometimes we're not able to, and you just need to slip out. That's okay to do so. please hear my heart today. When you're slipping out, if you just do it quietly and reverently, please know that we're glad that you're here. We say welcome to Praise Center. God bless you today. Amen. Can we take just a few moments to come and pray at the altar? God bless you today. Amen.